In a statement read by Judith Aliek, the woman representative for Kwale District, who also doubles as the chairperson of the Lango Parliamentary Group, they lashed out at Peter Ogwang, the Minister of State for Sports, for announcing that Akibwa Stadium had been struck off the list due to lack of funds and requisite infrastructure required by the Confederation of African Football, CAF, to host such a tournament.
Construction of two additional stadia to host the AFCON, Akibwa Stadium, Lira, and Buhinga Stadium in Fort Poto, or Hoima City Stadium in Hoima. Honorable Peter Ogwang, who, while appearing on a morning talk show in one of the local radios in Lango on the 13th of November, 2023, indicating that Akibwa Stadium would not be constructed to host AFCON 2027.
They called for an emergency meeting to be held with the president and the leaders from the region in order to address sentiments brewing within the region of being marginalized from the rest of the country.
Disappointed that Lango sub-region has been further marginalized and sidelined in the development of this country and unfairly excluded from hosting AFCON 2027 and from reaping benefits of infrastructure development, social transformation, and economic growth, contrary to the position stated by the Minister of Education and Sports.
The legislators wondered why the aspiration of the 2.5 million people in Lango sub-region should be sidelined in preference for Hamis Chigundu, who has fronted Nachivubo War Memorial Stadium.
We begin to ask ourselves whether the Lango people are valuable. We've seen stadiums constructed and named Mandela National Stadium to remember foreign heroes, but we are failing to see stadiums being constructed to remember our local heroes. Akibwa was the first Uganda national gold medalist in Olympics. It's now 50 years. We've remembered others who came after him, but we failed to remember him. What remains is just a very miserable shed that is being called Akibwa Stadium as we speak right now.
However, during today's plenary sitting, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, called for calm from Lango MPs, noting that such backlash can influence CAF to have a second thought on Uganda.
Let's not antagonize our bid for AFCON. This is an international thing. Let's not localize it. I also come from an area. Do you want us also on Sunday to say, No Soroti or Bukedia Stadium, no vote? No Isingiro? Honorable members, there was a decision in the parliament that they agreed. I don't know. Honorable Chris, do you remember the decision of parliament on this, putting up the stadiums in all the country? Do you remember? You will give it to us? Because we are not going to tolerate this.
Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania won the bid to host the 2027 Africa Cup of Nations. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.